Daniel Sharp. I'm with the Dakota Sharpshooters 4-H Club, and this is my 8th year in 4-H. I'm also 15 years old. Today, I'm going to be talking about the engineering project of the Popsicle Bridge. I chose this project because I am extremely interested in engineering. This is why I'm going to talk, speaking about the bridge to understanding. This is a basic picture of what my bridge hopefully will look like, with two support beams on the bottom, with a shorter beam running along the top, and then cross beams forming triangles for added support. And the bridge roadway here inside the triangle, spanning the gap. State fair regulations on this bridge state that it must span 50 centimeters, be more than 10 centimeters wide and 20 centimeters high. The bridge deck must be less than 5 centimeters above the lowest point. And also 3 centimeters of the bridge must be resting on the two tables of the span. They state that less than 100 popsicle sticks must be used. And the size of that popsicle stick is here. This is the size of the popsicle stick, as the state fair book states. They're to be connected, glued together, an all-purpose, non-toxic glue. The bridge deck itself must be covered with construction paper so that a matchbox or Hot Wheels-sized car is able to travel across it. And that is the standard, about 3.5 centimeters wide and 2 centimeters high. The steps that I took to build my bridge were broken down into four different steps. Firstly, to conduct research. Second, to draw a design. Third, to gather supplies. And finally, start building the actual bridge. Going back to the first step, conducting research. I looked online for different popsicle bridge ideas, and I just saw what others were doing, took some of the aspects of the bridges, and combined it into my own, as I showed you earlier. My idea in itself is original, but it did have some aspects of other people's bridges. And it's most important that you did not go over the number of popsicle sticks. So this bridge right here would probably not be what a bridge you would see, or the bridge at my title page. Second, to draw a design. What I did was I got a piece of graph paper and drew out what my bridge would look like. It was similar to this, with the triangular shape, with this being the bottom and the bridge running here. It helped me to include all the schematics, the lengths, so I am able to see this bridge in my head as I am creating it. Third, gather supplies. I showed you the standard size of the popsicle stick. I would get more than 100 so that if you mess up, you can have extras. And I would suggest using Elmer's wood glue, because the all-purpose glue doesn't work as well with wood. Also, wax paper. Because if you're gluing stuff down, chances are you're going to get glue on the surface, on your work surface, and you don't want it to stay there, so I would put wax paper down. And finally, clamps, such as this. This is to hold the pieces together as the glue is drying, because an airtight glue seal makes it stronger. And finally, start building your bridge. To form the main support beams, start gluing the sticks together in a two-ply fashion, such as this. I'll show you a close-up later on. The two-ply method makes the support stronger than just a single popsicle stick. Once the lawn supports are finished, you can start connecting them, as I showed you in my bridge example. Connect the supports by gluing them together with popsicle sticks to form triangular shapes. And be sure to make the bridge deck. So you may be asking yourself, why triangles? Why would you use triangles in a bridge? You use triangles because they are the strongest geometrical shape because of their fixed angles. Such as with a square, if you put a load on it, it could fold. A triangle will not do that. You put a load here, the force will be evenly distributed throughout the entire triangle, or if you put it here, the same principle is applied. And this is why triangles are used in bridge design today. Now in depth on building the supports. Stagger two layers of popsicle sticks and glue them together to form the double ply rod. Be sure to clamp the two layers together while the glue is drying. Again, to form that strong airtight seal. This would be an example of that two-ply. With popsicle stick here, I cut them in half so that they would line up evenly. But this length two-ply beam is stronger than just a single popsicle stick. And what I did for the actual bridge deck or the roadway was I cut the corners off the popsicle stick to form a triangular edge. This new shape will interlock with others of the same kind to form an even roadway. The standard matchbox car is about as wide as 3 to 4 of these sticks. So this would be what the roadway would look like. With this whole shape being a popsicle stick and interlocking together to form the roadway. So in conclusion, there are 4 main steps that I would suggest to using to build a popsicle stick bridge. The first being to conduct research. Second, to draw out your design. Third, to gather the necessary supplies. And fourth, to start building the bridge. If you follow these steps and the tips and tricks that I showed you, you will find the bridge to understanding. Are there any questions?
Your bridge is finished?
It is not.
So we are still building the bridge too. Okay. So
it doesn't understand.
You estimate then, when you started your process of building your bridge too, when you think you might finish it, about how long is that going to take?
Probably a couple of weeks. A
couple of weeks. Have you been taking pictures of the progress of your bridge as you've been doing?
I'm still on the draw the design phase.
How many pieces of graph paper has it? That's all right.
Mental graph.
Yeah.
Usually mental graph paper.
Mental graph paper looks good. How much weight, other than just it needs to be the width for a matchbox car, does it need to be able to support a certain amount of weight or no?
It does need to support a load.
How many popsicle sticks would you probably take or something?
I would try and utilize all if not most of the 100 popsicle sticks. Any other questions?
Have you built a bridge like this before out of popsicle sticks?
I've not built a bridge, but I've built load-bearing structures out of balsa wood. But this is totally new to me, so. Thank you for your time.